Now listen.
I'm like erosion.
Listen to me, folks. I've told you about this Joe Buck. I keep telling to you over and over and over again. Okay? I am telling you, Joe Buck no longer likes the sport of baseball. In fact, dare I say, he hates it.
Wow.
He's only into football. When you listen to the NFL broadcasts, that's the only time his voice has any juice in him anymore. That's it. You hear him on the Saturday day game. He sounds like he wants to stab poor Tim McCarver for crying out loud. Tim McCarver can't say a word without Joe Buck jumping down his throat. Okay? And then you have Joe Buck, and his voice literally sounds different. So we have some audio here. This is Yankees-Cubs. Yankees are up 4-2 in the game. And no men on. Mariano's in the game. Gives up a solo home run that would make it 4-2.
A three.
4-3, that's right, with a nice fun little accent.
Thank you.
Given to us by the Sean O. So that's what the score should be. But let's take a listen to Joe Buck's call, if you will.
That's well hit in the left. And target it. Jake Johnson is tying it. Now a 4-3 game, I beg your pardon. A two-run game, now a one-run game. It's 4-3 here in the ninth.
He says it twice, too. He said it twice.
Yeah. Yeah. Didn't even acknowledge his mistake.
And seriously, we'll take another listen just for the screw-up part. Listen to his voice. I mean, what happened to Joe Buck? The same guy who's able to deliver with power, you know, what Randy Moss did is despicable. He doesn't sound like himself anymore.
He's dead inside.
He really is. Let's listen. Let's do it again.
That's well hit in the left. And target it. Ray Johnson is tying it. Now a 4-3 game.
Okay, there you go. That's all. Nope. So the other thing about that is that he so badly wants the Yankees to lose every game that he calls, that he broadcasts.
Can't stand that.
He's such a Midwesterner that he cannot take any East Coast. I'm not even talking about I'm talking about the East Coast in general.
Yeah.
He would not mind if the Yankees and Red Sox and Phillies all just died in three strange Twilight Zone-ish plane crashes all at the same time.
Disband the franchises, basically.
Disband them. And everyone moved to St. Louis. Joe Buck wants the St. Louis Browns back.
Who doesn't?
The worst team in the history of sports. So someone needs to tell Joe Buck, you know what, Joe? Honestly, just hang up your baseball shoes. You like doing football more. Big deal. Big deal, man. Okay?
Thanks for letting me know.
And Tim McCarver just sits there like a battered child. Like, you know, Tim McCarver is just frightened. Because I'm telling you, Tim McCarver says one word, and Joe Buck just, he shuts up. Because Joe Buck is always doing some sarcastic insult at poor Tim McCarver at his expense.
He's like a beaten wife.
He really is. He almost seems like he's, like, trapped there. Like he's Arnold in the back of the bicycle shop in that one Different Strokes episode where he and Dudley almost got, you know, let's just say Pulp Fiction, almost got medievaled on there, you know what.
Never saw it. Mm-hmm.
You never saw that episode?
Come on.
You're too busy getting drunk when you were six. That was the problem.
Possibly.
You started early.
Now the world's all new.
Yeah, I was probably getting liquored up at six.
You never saw
it? I think that was it.
You never saw Different Strokes?
I can't remember. Which one was Different Strokes?
Arnold
Which
Drummond?
One was Different Strokes?
What are you talking about?
Gary
Willis?
Coleman.
Oh, was that with the old white man, right?
Yeah, the guy actually was Mr. Carlson from WKRP in Cincinnati.
Oh, okay. Conrad.
All right, Conrad.
Yeah.
Oh, that's Conrad.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Yeah. Conrad Bain was the father.
I get it mixed up with Belvedere.
Way different.
Yeah.
Belvedere?
They were on at the same time, right?
Sometimes.
No, Belvedere was on a little bit afterwards.
No, I mean same era. I mean, say
no. Belvedere was on afterwards.
Wait, seriously?
Am I not speaking out loud?
I thought maybe you're throwing, like, you know, the time slot.
No. Belvedere was on a little bit afterwards.
Were those primetime TV shows?
Of course they were primetime. Really?